Okay, so I wasn't filming before. Okay, so these are the colors I'm using for the blooms. Yellow Evol, apple green Evol, rich violet Evol, lake blue Evol, and rose gold, rose red gold Evol, and Pearlex Super Russet. They are all mica powders. Okay, now it's working. Here we go. So I'm going to put the cushion on first, which is Sherwin-Williams satin. Interior, exterior house paint. Give it a little spin. Gorgeous, and I think I will give you the names of that after on a little tiny video. So I'm ready to go. I don't want to use as much paint as I used last time. I'm going to use a little different color scheme. Hot color. I'm going to stir everything, so this needs a little stir. These are all mica colors. Okay, gotta do that. There's a lot of prep work you have to do first. Sometimes I forget some things. So I'm going to put some of this hot color. That's it. And then I'm going to put some yellow. Or gold. It's a beautiful gold, and I did forget to stir that too, so I'm going to stir that too. A little stir. If they've been sitting 24 hours, they need a little stir. Okay. And I might switch to using. Hold on a minute. Bubbles. I'm trying to get rid of them just so I don't use as much paint. Same colors as I used yesterday, basically. A little differently. We're experimenting with this stuff, so see what happens. Rose gold, another gorgeous color, rose gold. And I'm going to use a spoon again because I tend to dump too much paint otherwise. A little more control this way. Used put the CA on. Okay. So I'm going to start, I think, with this here. It's a regular cake knife. And I'm going to put some on black on the back. Cell activator made with Australian flow trowel. A little bit of a white. Made these up just this morning. So I ran out of them yesterday. Oh, that's quite enough. I don't want to waste any of this stuff. Oh my goodness. It's really an exciting formula. I'm going to just put some of this in here. Let that cell activator keep. I don't want to disturb this. And I'm going to use my little knife, my smaller palette knife, to just take this, these gorgeous things here. And smear them into here. Or let them just drop into there. I'm not going to even smear them into there. Might from here. Oh. We haven't even spun it yet. I'm going to take a little more of the black cell activator, clean the knife off, and just put it through here. See if I could just bring up a few more cells. Not too much. Not too much of this. Spin off anyway, so I would say it's spinning time now. Let's do some spinning and let this stuff grow. Before I let it grow, I think I'm going to let this come down a little, because I want a lot of that to stay in the center. So far, it's looking pretty exciting. Let's see what happens when I bring this down a little. See if it'll move for me. See if I get it to move down a little bit. Yes, it is. Yeah. Okay, not too much. And a little tiny bit up. A little bit over. Oh yeah, I want this to grow. I want that to grow. Spin, so I don't want to go up too much. Okay, you ready? Woo-hoo. Look what's happening, people.
Wipe my hands again.
Before I do that, I'm going to just take my straw and just blow some of this right in the center. smaller, but right. This will probably blow off, so I'm not worried about that. I hate to see that blow off. So what I might do is, let go over that way, just to leave it more. This doesn't blow up entirely. It's awfully gorgeous. Okay, that's enough. I don't want this blowing off. So let me bring it back just a little bit. I'm just excited about these gorgeous cells. The cell activator is incredible. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Exciting part. Spinning. See what happens. Which way? Let's try this way first. I'm not going to give it too much of a spin. I want to see which way things are growing. Okay. That's what I thought was going to happen. That's going to go off. So let me lift it and just pull it back a little bit again. Since I can. Pull it back a little bit again. One more. Okay. Okay, we're going to spin again. I want to go the other way now. It's not spinning real hard. Wow. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. That is so gorgeous. I want to go that way again a little bit more. It is moving. As long as it's moving, I can do this. I want some of that white at the top to go off. It will. Angling it a certain way. Oh wow. Look at that, people. I don't even see that. Okay. So I'm going to give it another spin. I don't want that going off. So let me just, again, as long as she's willing to move, and that's the first time I've actually worked with bloom pores that they're willing to move. Fantastic. Okay. Now we're going to give it a spin. Small spin. Okay. Gorgeous. Look at these little mini cells happening up in here. Wow. It's really a gorgeous piece. Not crazy about that white. I think it's going. The cells are growing every time I spin it. That is incredible. I think we're going to stop there. I'd like this to come down a little more again. Let's see if I can get it to do that. And I think it is. And it's making this... Okay, that's good. That's enough. Let's see if I can get this. Whoop. Almost dropped it. If I can get this white off here in the corner. I don't like that white in the corner. There it goes. It's going now. Okay, but I don't want to lose where I've stopped. Can you see that? Isn't that amazing? That is amazing. And like I said, the formula, the PM, the pouring medium changed, the everything changed.
I'll bring the camera.
Wow. Okay. I'm zoomed in a little too much. Whoops, that's not what I want. Okay, look the other way. Okay, perfect. So it's sitting right now on a these yogurt cups like that. To dry. I'm hoping my table is dry. I mean level. And because usually pores do not, these blooms do not move. But these are. But look at the beautiful array of cells. Look at that. Cell into the cell into the cell one more gorgeous color, some lacing down here. Oh, dreamy, dreamy colors. Look at this. Oh, look at the veins through the cells from the black activator. Okay, that's it for now. I'll be on to number two soon. Okay, so it has a cushion just like we do with regular stuff. This is a tile. But the cushion is Sherwin Williams satin. It's what she uses. And it's straight out of here. You don't put any Floetrol in it. So it's pretty thick, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty thick. And that much should do it. And then you spin it once. I mean, you could tilt it to make it go, but spinning is much easier. How fast it spreads out.
Mm-hmm.
Just make sure all my sides are done. So it's shiny already because it has a, this paint is satin. So it already has a little shine to it.
Not what we used on, I think, the red last week?
I think we used it.
Or was it white?
Yeah, they usually use flat. They usually use flat house paint for pores, regular pores. Okay, so I'll just put this here for a moment. So the paints have been made up. I made them yesterday. I'll show you what mica paints look like if you have time. So what I'm going to do is, they've already been stirred and everything. The difference with this is the cell activator is not the silicone like we use. I'm going to use a different method here today. I'm just going to go, it's already shiny, the paint, because because of the formula. So I'm going to try with that first. I'm going to mix it up a little bit and see what I had, the layers there. See how shiny they are?
Mm-hmm. That red looks really nice.
Mica paint with the beautiful already, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna put the red. Okay, I'm gonna put some green. I'm going to a little bit different colors than I used with that, but it'll be basically the same. You can just put them on with instead of doing what I'm doing, you can put them on with a spoon, which I don't know what I did with the spoon. I'll just use this one. Let's use this one. So you don't use so much. A little more control with a spoon.
Mm.
And you could just pretty randomly put that in there. Okay. And put a little blue. Thickness in here, and more thickness in here, because it was thick here, so I just wanted to show off the blue a little bit more. And this is a gold yellow. Okay, so I mean, you can do it this way, but it doesn't really save a whole lot. I know you can do it quickly, it's fine. Sometimes I do want it thicker anyway, that yellow. And just rose gold. Yes, look at that.
Yes.
And that's the formula that she uses too, the PM. This is not just Floetrol. This is a special paint that I haven't yet at the store. A special name. Now these are the cell activators instead of the cell activator we use, which is the coconut cream and silicone. This is CA. And that magic Floetrol. This is cell activator. So
it's black.
I'm not. Sometimes you put it right in there, but I've been getting these kind of effects by using either palette knife, and you put it on the back. So you do like a swiping thing. You can use different sizes of these, have different effects that way. And I'm going to put a little white cell activator with it. Gonna act like a swipe. You ready for this? Make sure my camera's going. Yes. themselves.
Oh, wow. Instant.
Lots of cells. I have tried to get this for 2 years, and I just wouldn't give in to buying the other flow trout. So I'm going to use the other knife now. Look at that.
The rainbows. Wow.
So I'm going to just use a little bit more on the smaller. This little one. Okay. Instant glorious cells. And I was so excited yesterday. I made up the paint for about 2 hours. And then I was so excited. I thought, Mom, I can't wait till tomorrow. I'm gonna do the two tonight. So I'm gonna put that in there. Just to get some of that black activated. And I'm gonna just swipe a little bit. That's pretty much first part. Look at the cells coming up.
Jeez.
So usually I'd make the cells come up a little bit for a little time, but for time's sake, and they're still popping up. And they still might pop up even after I spin it, because you will spin it, now you'll spin it, and everything will grow. Look at this. Look at this. Just in moments. Okay, I gotta do this quick for you.
That was, just my alarm.
And it's still making a lot of, look at these things popping up. And that's from the swiping. That's from the swiping with the cell activator.
Look at those colors. And they just keep, like, becoming more vibrant.
Well, a lot of it's the color I used. And also, with the cell activator swiping through it, that's what's doing that. Mm. And I watched Kathy Miller the other day, and I wrote down her formulas. And I thought, by golly, I'm going to get that darn stuff. This is a little boring in here. Now, what's on the edge here is probably going to go off anyway. Just like what pours is on the edge, usually goes off first.
Oh, so you don't just keep that, you spin it.
You're going to spin, well, there's a lot of paint on here. Not as much as a pour, because you saw how much I put through the middle. Really not that much. So, it doesn't use a whole lot of paint, and I could probably make 2 or 3 more tiles with what's left here. So I think we've waited. Oh, look at this. Look at the colors. Look at the cells. Look at the. Now, I don't like this part that much, so what I did with that one was I tipped this off a little bit, which usually this, a bloom does not move for me, but for some reason this one is. So I'm just going to tip this off a little bit and let that grow a little bit because I want a little more. I don't want to lose those ones up there. Okay. A lot of this is going to, some of this is going to spin off anyway. Okay. Maybe a little bit down this way. I don't need so much. Look at that, growing already. Woo-hoo. So exciting when it works. Okay, a lot of that's going to spin off, so let me not do, oops. That'll have to do something bad with a skewer. I don't like that. What happened there? Skewer, where did you go? I lost it already. I lost it. Oh, here it is. Not very obvious, but we can just get rid of it now. That's it. I think that was it. Okay, good. Those bubbles right now. You don't ever use a burner on this. Torch. Mm. No torch.
Probably catch fire.
Well, it's the kind of paint that'll make a skin on it right away if you use heat on it. So whatever's going to happen is happening chemically. Look at this gorgeous stuff. I put some of this on the rocks yesterday. I just grabbed it and put it on our rocks. But they kind of got muddy. Okay, watch this now. This is a gentle one. and they grow. See, they grew.
Wow.
I know. I know. Not crazy about that. I could grab some stuff on the corner here. Put some of that back in here. And see what happens. I need a wider one. This isn't wide enough. This gray for the rocks, what's down there. Maybe after you leave, I'll dip it into the rock into it once I move this. That helped a little bit. Yeah, the wider one is a little better for this. So you don't want it to look contrived. You want it to look like it was part of the core to begin with. So that's why I'm going to give it just another spin. This is growing a lot. So every time you spin it, something will happen. It'll usually grow because it's going off the sides and stretching. White's growing a lot, which I don't necessarily like, but I like that it's repeated down here. So it kind of comes down like that, which is good. That's the stuff I just put in. I kind of added something in there. You can also make little tails and things. So that's it. I just want you to see that. You can go. I just want you to see what
No, I love it. I mean,
what the blooms look like. And maybe next year, if you keep up with this. Okay, so we finished this pour. And I don't think I'm going to spin it out anymore. I think it's got enough paint off of it. So I'm going to just lift it up and wipe off the excess. I think you're seeing this pretty good. Okay, down here you will. Okay, wipe off the excess stuff off the bottom and then put it in a nice place to dry, and then I will show you a close-up on it. It made again thanks to the formula from Kathy Miller. If you want to see the formula, go to Kathy Miller on YouTube. Go to her thing where it says her new formula. That's what I used, was her new formula. And I have been trying for 2 years to get this much effect of cells. And I mean, I've still made pretty decent pieces. But this is what makes the cells. Cells meaning all this stuff that's going on here. That sells. And it was a combination of her formula plus the new cell activator, which she calls black magic or something like that. Okay, so I'll put it over here to dry. There you go. Now I think you can see it. And then I will come back and show you what it looks like. So that's it. I'm sorry about the light. That's how it turned out. Sorry about the light. Some beautiful, beautiful effects on this piece. It's a tile at 8.5 inches. It will have a cork back on it. And that's the other one. Both have cork back, and most likely I will put high gloss finish on it, or the glossy already, but just for protection, or epoxy. That's that for today. Have a great day, guys. Push the cushion down first. Spin it out. That's good. This is regular satin. Sherwin-Williams interior exterior. I'm using Kathy's formula, Kathy Miller. You can look her up on YouTube. She's incredible. Get rid of that bubble, give it a little stir, and I'm going to put it right in the middle. That's enough. Next, I'm going to put the gold. And then I'm going to put I'm going to put the green. These are mica paints. All of them are mica paints. With Kathy Miller's PM pouring medium formula. Okay. Put the purple, a bit of purple. This one I'm going to do differently. I'll do that one this way. And I'm going to put in the rose gold. Beautiful color. Now, you do use a lot less paint when you do it this way. I think I got all my colors. I think I'm going to just put the yellow again. Okay. And this time, I'm not going to use the white CA at all. I'm going to just use the black CA. Right in the middle. Okay, and it has that spring to it, which it's supposed to have, that spring back. And here we go. Now we're going to blow. I'm going to blow, and I'm going to come in a little closer with the blowing. Let me see if my thing will do it here. just put a little tiny bit like she, they do. Let me just put a tiny little bit like they do. And mix this up a little bit. Tiny little bit like they do. Just a tiny bit. I'm just going to experiment with this. So I am. Uh-huh. Because it didn't work. The last one didn't work. So let's try it a little different. Don't know why those... I mean, they don't put a lot of paint in the middle on these. That's enough. Whoa. What the heck is that? I don't know. Okay. I put the gold, the green, put the blue, put the purple. I think we're ready to go. So what do you want to do? This time we do just a white. No. I'm going to just do the white. Uh-huh. Let's see what happens with just the white. Is it running? Yeah. This just happens with just the white. Maybe it's a little. It is making a halo. That's good. The white's making a halo. I'm going to just put a dot of black CA in there too. So this is take two. See if I get better results with this. I'm going to let that halo form again first on the CA. What's that bubble? What's the bubble? Good. That's the bubbles. Okay, let's try it out. Let's try it. So let's try blowing. Alright, we're getting some cells out there now. That's good. This is better. Oh, I think this is better. Use the... I think we might get better results with this, I hope. Better. This might be better. A lot's happening. I'm gonna take in for a second to show you. This is kind of muddy in here, but the rest of it looks good. Hopefully that's gonna go off. In fact, we're gonna try to get it off. Just let it go that way, just a wee bit. Nothing's gonna move. See what happens when I spin it. It's got a lot of potential cell there. Let's see what happens when I spin it. What's happening? Yeah, see, that's what I don't want growing, is that white. And I want this going off. Let's see if I can get that and go off before. That's some white canvas showing. I better get that off. I don't like that at all. That at all. Do love that. I don't want that going off. Do not want that going off. Scott doesn't have a whole lot of paint. That is stunning. I might leave that just like that. Just fix my corners there. That is stunning. Much better than what I had the last time. Yes, it is. Okay, that's it there. Wipe my hands off. Get some of this gray off. Take up some of the white. I get pure white right out of the can here. I'm just going to go for the pure white and clean this corner. That is an amazing piece. That's pretty. I say, you know, it really pays to try again. It really does. And I like it with the whites and just this thing in the middle. It's really stunning. I might make just a couple of little rolling, so I'm going to let it keep rolling because it's a pain to turn it on and off. We're going to do another piece. This is very good cushion. I like how it works. The Sherwin-Williams straight out of the bottle. She doesn't put any thinner in it at all. Just straight out of the bottle. And that's just about covered everywhere. Okay, it's got corners. Corners are the culprits usually. Yes, a little tiny. It has slowed down quite a bit. Wow, quite a bit. Yeah, I'm liking this. Liking this a lot. Just gentle spin. Gentle spin. Just make those grow a little. Okay, kind of spill that off the side, which might have been a mistake. This is gorgeous. This is like a butterfly or something. I just want to get some more of these lines. Oh wow. Yeah, I like that. I like these lines. I like these lines. I think we need them in here too, because I got some of this great stuff off. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Let me try it with a skewer, which, hope it's pointy enough. I think it is. Green. All right. What do you think? Let me show it to you. Let me think. I think this is it. I love it. I love it. It's a beautiful tile. It's got very butterfly type of look to it. Oh, it's gorgeous. Look at that. Here's the wings. Here's the other wing. It's very beautiful tile. Okay, shut this off a little bit. Okay, there we go. Gorgeous piece. Okay, last one. Yeah, I am. I think I found out by doing just tiny small circles. It spreads out to the outer rim much better. South Pacific mix here. Hot color here. In the middle. And I'm going to repeat some things. Repeat the green. I'm not going to use as many colors this time. I'm not adding purple. I'm going to repeat the blue. Definitely going to repeat the, I guess, the yellow. So I'm doing a doubling up on the color, but not the amounts, not making them big again, just small. Let's see how this Pacific-y looking type of thing. And I'm going to do just the black. Whoops. Just the black cell activator. Put this in the middle again. It's hardly moving. Paint might be thickening up a little bit from sitting so long. I'm going to put a little bit more black this time. And a dot of the white. So these are the cell activators at the end. And a dot of the white. Yeah, I think maybe the small amounts for this kind of a pour. For this kind of a blowing thing, it's definitely better. And I think using the straw. Different colors this time. Oh yeah. Let's see what's growing on the edge. That's really a small circle. I wouldn't mind getting rid of this entirely. So I'm just leaving it right where it is. Waiting a few moments for these to come up a little bit more. And they'll come up more when you spin it too. I like the way the white made these branches. Let's see if I can make that happen a little bit more, with a little bit more blowing into that white. All right, let's see what happens when I spin this baby out. Ready? I like this blue and green. It's a little different color combination that I put in. Here we go. Oh, it hardly moved. That's interesting. I know why. I forgot to put the cushion on. Oh dear. Let's see if I could still do it. I don't know. I was wondering why it wasn't moving. Alright. Let's put the cushion right up to that. To that spot there, right up to the piece, and hopefully that'll make it move, because it just stopped dead in its tracks. It was not gonna move. You didn't tell me. Why didn't you tell me and put the cushion? Okay. Hey, now you're just observers. Just observing. Alright, let's see what happens. Hopefully it'll grab it. I hope it grabs it. I forgot to put the cushion. How about that? Well, maybe I should have put a black cushion while it wasn't down. Oh, isn't that pretty? Now let's see what happens when we spin it out. See what happens. Hopefully it's going to catch that cushion now. We'll see. Then we find out, don't we? Okay, here we go. That's a little. Wow. I don't know. I forgot to put the cushion down. I don't think she's moving. I might have to swipe it to make it move. One more time. Down a little, but hardly moved. Big mistake, not putting the cushion down first. Forgot to. All right, let's try just swiping it and see what happens. I'm gonna load it with some, too bad, the colors are pretty. I'm gonna load it with some black. Heck, see what happens. Some white, a little bit of white, and black CA. I think I make plenty of that. It's not moving, not budging. So I'm gonna just swipe it and see what happens. It's pretty. I think I'm gonna get just a lot of black and white. It's pretty cool, actually. Black and white cells are beautiful. Let's go through here and see what happens. I'll leave that white right there. Okay, let's see. Big mistake. Well, I'm gonna spin it right away. I'm gonna let the cells come up. Well, they are coming up. A lot are coming up. I'm gonna put some black cell activator on here. And just run this through here like this. It's pretty cool. Wonderful mistakes, you know? Are not really mistakes. They're just experiences that lead you to a greater experience. I'm gonna spin it. I don't know if that's gonna move at all. Ooh. Getting pretty exciting, actually. Let's go the other way. Growing. I think they're finally starting to move. Oh yeah. That's more. I don't want to do too much. I think that's pretty cool. That's a pretty cool tile. What do you think? I'll have to bring you in to take a look at it. Do you think that's a cool enough tile to keep? It's still developing cells. It's pretty, pretty exciting, I think. Let's see what happens if I blow on it with a straw, if I make the cells a little bigger. Hold on a minute. Yeah, I like this. I really do. Totally different than the other one, and it's totally different than what I started with, but I really, really like it. Totally different. It's more black and white. See if I can get the screen smaller. There we go. Some really cool stuff happening in there. Huh? Yeah? Keeper? I think so. I think it's a keeper. Okay. Clean it up and put it out to dry. Two more stupendous pours today using the Kathy Miller formula. Just really exciting stuff happening with that formula. Wow. Look at this stuff. Oh, goodness. Here's the other one. They both will be cork-backed, and they will be for sale. The six-sided one is about 8.5 inches. It'll probably go for about 95, and the smaller one will go for 50. So these are just, wow.